today, well, Melinda, in the morning at least, and on court two, Mary Pierce, who served up a double bagel to her opponent in round one to take on Eleni Daniladou from Greece. To call the match, Mal Washington and Mary Jo Fernandez.
Thanks, Chris. We appreciate it. We welcome everyone out to court number two, where Mary Pierce from France, a two-time Grand Slam winner, Mary Pierce at the bottom of your screen, taking on from Greece, Eleni Daniladou, the 14th seed. Mary Pierce to serve along with Mary Jo Fernandez, Malavia Washington here. Both of these two players getting through their opening rounds very easily. As Chris had mentioned, Mary Pierce threw in straight sets and not much more difficult for Daniladou in her first round.
That's right, Daniladou had an easy 2-2 win. Mary Pierce has not won a match this year at the Slam, so it's nice for her to win her first round here at Wimbledon.
30 left.
Two good points from Pierce. Pierce has been struggling on and off with injuries. She's had every injury under the sun, Mal, from ankles to wrists to stomach pulls. Her back was what kept her out most of 2001 after she won the 2000 French Open.
And that's been 13, the case 15. Pretty much, you know, throughout the last 6-7 years of her career.
It's been very frustrating for Pierce. As you see, Daniladou, talented Greek player, can pretty much do it all on the court, has a beautiful one-handed backhand. She'll try to find her way to net as well.
14-15.
Mary Pierce, the ace out wide, looking to serve and volley. A couple of game points.
Game, Miss Pierce.
Solid first game for Mary Pierce, continuing what she was able to do in her first round match, where she was winning 95% of her first serve points in. There's a look at the stands on court number two, also called the graveyard court, because over the years, this seems to be the court where so many seeds fall to lower ranked players. Here's a look at the two players. Mary Pierce turning pro at 14 years old in 2 months, now 28 years old. Half her career as a pro.
She's been ranked as high as number 3 in the world. She's 86 right now, trying to get her form back. Daniladou, 20 years old. Her rankings dropped to 21. She was just 14 last week. That's why she's the 14th seed here at Wimbledon.
15 left.
She won her first pro tournament, Daniladou, last year on the grass in Holland. This year chose to play Eastbourne instead and lost first round. So she lost all those points and therefore dropped in the rankings.
15 love. These two have never played before, but a nice play from Mary Pierce. You don't see her, in my opinion, you don't really see her making that aggressive move like that from the baseline, trying to make her way to the net.
No, you don't. I mean, we're used to seeing Mary Pierce win her points from blasting from the baseline, but so far in this match, we've seen her try to serve and volley and there, take the ground stroke and follow it in. Nice feel for Pierce.
13-15.
Nice serve out wide, an effective serve on the grass. Daniladou got to the fourth round here last year. It's where she made her big breakthrough. She lost three tight sets to Jennifer Capriati. This year we saw her in Australia lose in the fourth round to Serena Williams, where she played a very good match, except her serve got the yips during that match. Really struggled with a lot of double faults.
Even though she got through her first round pretty comfortably, Daniladou, she was averaging about a double fault a game in her first round match. And that is an example of what you were just saying. And you called it perfectly, Mary Jo.
How about that timing, Mal?
I mean, that was a horrible second serve.
And I think that's one of the causes this year for Daniladou not having won as many matches as we were expecting her. Her serve has really let her down. Her ball toss goes awry at times, and she doesn't get full extension. There you see it again, first serve, mishits it almost at the bottom of the net.
And, well, you know, with a player like Mary Pierce who loves to jump on second serves, that's not a good sign early on.
That's very well played by Pierce, who, Mal, by the way, When we talk about great hitters of the ball, great strikers of the ball, we say Capriati, Davenport, but Pierce is right there. I mean, if she's set up to hit the ball, she hits a heavy ball, and you can see she's not scared to come in and take balls out of the air.
And now Mary Pierce with her first break point for a 2-love lead.
Still struggling to get the rhythm on the serve, Danilo Du.
And for a player, speaking of Danilo Du, with such a big game, and she's a big hitter of the ball, surprising that her serve isn't more of an asset for her. Danilo Du, 20 years old from Greece, one of the best known Greek athletes in the world. Not just tennis, certainly in tennis, but in the world. Danilo Du will be representing her country next year in the Olympics. When the Olympics are in Athens, she's hoping to be the flag bearer for her country.
She's so excited about it. She talks about the Olympics being in her home country next year, and you could just see her face light up. She's one of the nicest players on the tour. I compare her right up there with Kim Clijsters. Extremely friendly with everyone.
Break point number two.
Key for Danilo Du in this match is really to get Pierce out of her strike zone. Pierce has been struggling with her shape. She's been trying to work out a little bit harder. She just reunited with her old coach, Sven Grunfeld. This is the third time they get back together. Sven Grunfeld was with Pierce when she won the 95 Australian Open, and then again in 97 got her back in the top 10.
Well, some pretty good fortune on that point from Mary Pierce. I don't think Mary Pierce thought
advantage, Miss Pierce.
I don't think Mary Pierce thought Danilo Du actually got that on one bounce. Here's another look at it. No, not even close to getting it on one bounce. And she has another break point, number three. But you mentioned Mary Pierce getting in shape. That's kind of been one of her issues the last several years. And if you look at just her game and how powerful her game is, one of her deficiencies has always been in the movement area.
That's absolutely right. Never been a great mover. She became an effective mover, worked really hard off the court with her physical trainer, Mark Versteegen, who works out of Arizona now. Mary spends quite a bit of time in Arizona with him. They work on specifics on the court, how to cut off angles, how to get a better first step to the ball, and he really did help her in winning her majors. But the reason Mary Pierce likes playing on the faster surfaces is because when she hits the ball that big on grass, it normally doesn't come back. It's tougher to get Mary on the defense on this surface.
Especially with returns like that. You're starting out the point on defense. Another break point.
Mary right on that baseline.
See if she can produce a double fault here. Intimidate the server a little bit.
Deuce.
Make sure you stay with us all day. We'll be having a lot of coverage from Wimbledon on center court today. Tim Henman is in action against Michael Lodra. Andre Agassi will be in action over on court number one, along with Serena Williams.
Danilo Du, you can see how she can jerk you around the court.
Advantage miss, Danny Ledoux.
A lot of shot selections. Goes for the drop shot. Great disguise. Pierce did not know whether she was going to slice it deep. And as we mentioned, the movement is the weakness in the Pierce game.
So after saving four break points, she now has a game point of her own.
Okay, miss Danny Ledoux.
And Mary Pierce loses her first game of the championship.
One game more.
One all. Here's a look at where this court is. That area right there on your top left, that's the most recent addition to the grounds here at Wimbledon. Court number two we're on right now.
That third level is where the players have lunch and they like to come over and watch the matches on this court.
Well, from that third level, you're able to see not only court number two, three, four, and five, and then some of the courts even, you know, a little further back, further behind.
Got away with a not so good drop shot, Mary Pierce, on that point. But she followed it in, so it forced Danny Ledoux to try to find the opening for the pass.
I like the idea from inside the baseline trying that, but maybe not enough disguise on it. 15 all.
Chicken charge. You can see Danny Ledoux put the pressure on Pierce with the second serve. It was a good chip and charge approach, but Pierce finding the opening stayed very low to hit that pass.
30-15. 40-15.
I'm seeing a little few more plays out of Mary Pierce that I haven't seen in the past when she's played on grass. We've seen her a few times try to sneak in and take the ball out of the air. There again on that point, serve and volleying on the serve out wide.
Well, I think she realizes that if she doesn't come in, her opponent will. And she's trying to take the net away from Danny Ledoux.
And again, Mary Pierce making her way to the net, putting away the volley. And takes a 2-1 lead, the grounds of Wimbledon. We're coming back.
Let's go back to Mary Pierce and Eleni Danny Ledoux out on court two. Matt Washington and Mary Jo Fernandez. Matt.
Thanks, Chris. Appreciate it. Two games all. Danny Ledoux held serve in the previous game, and again, it was a struggle, as was her opening service game. Mary Pierce serving at the bottom of the screen, 15 love.
By Pierce, who's serving so far now very well.
30 love.
She's getting 75% of her serves in. She hasn't faced a break point, and she knows that Danny Ledoux is going to be attacking the second serve. But we've been impressed with her net play. We're used to seeing her swing away from the baseline, but not attack the net so often.
Putting away a pretty easy volley there, 30 love. But on a couple of occasions, including that last point, I think she's gotten away with some very average drop shots.
Time it was Danny Ledoux getting away with an average approach shot up the middle of the court. Pierce with a lot of time to look at the pass.
That's one of those points where you just hit the approach. It's a bluff. You just come in and you kind of put the pressure on your opponent to make the passing shot. Mary Pierce could not. For the first time, Mary Pierce is the 30 all on her own serve. She's had a couple of easy service games.
Saw Mary Pierce yesterday in the gym doing a lot of ab work, trying to get fitter. It's some foot drills as well with her coach, Sven Grunfeld.
Doing some foot drills yesterday, you say?
Yes. Well, first break point coming up for Danila Du.
Let for serve.
Grunfeld, by the way, recently was working with Rozetsky. And now is back with Mary Pierce. This is actually their third time working together.
Now a second serve on break point from Mary Pierce. See if Danila Du tries to come in as she has on a couple of occasions. Well, Danila Du played a very nice point, floating that approach shot close to the baseline. She had the volley she wanted to and came up with the error.
Not a bad tactic from Pierce to throw in that lob. It's important early on when you play someone who's rushing the net to establish that you can hit an offensive lob so they don't crowd the net so much. Because Danila Du really likes to get close on top of the net.
Keeps them honest a little bit. Back to Deuce. Danila Du is down. She looks like she might have gone over on her ankle, and she's slow to get up. It's like it was that right ankle that went over, but she signals to Pierce that she's okay. Well, actually, her ankle didn't go over. She just
was lucky.
Slipped and went down. That's what happens when you get out, you know, on the edges of the court where the grass is still kind of green and it can still be a little slick. Pierce with a game point.
Kept that slice low, Danila Du. I think Pierce is going to be better off playing more into the Danila Du forehand. She's going to get a higher bounce off that shot, even though Danila Du might hit a few more winners on that side. It's a side that has more unforced errors. And also that slice is just so effective on the grass that she can work her way in with the slice.
Deuce. Pierce is going to have to make that decision. Does she go to the forehand side that has more power? Here's another look at the forehand from Danila Du.
Did a little head fake. And guessed right, Pierce at the net. Kept moving in forward, too. And this is a good move by Pierce. Again, she's not known for her good feel, good hands at the net.
Game point. Just a little bit too good. Mary Pierce holds off a break point, takes a 3-2 lead. See if Danila Du still has the yips on her serve.
Court, we'll keep it posted. Mary Pierce up 3-2. Back to Mal, Mary Jo.
Thanks, gents. Mary Pierce is up 3-2 and has a 30-love lead in this game. The yips have continued on the serve of Danila Du. She started out the game with a double fault, a bad double fault, and here's a forehand winner to give Mary Pierce three break points.
Now she's just trying to push her serve in to Danila Du and paying the price.
15-14.
Pierce paying the price going to the backhand side of Danila Du. What a great shoulder turn.
That's Danila Du's favorite shot. She can hit over it, she can slice it. Gives that one a good rip.
Still break point.
30-14.
Mary Pierce not playing the break points as well as she can. She's got to put that ball back in the court.
She's 0-for-6 right now. She had four break points earlier on in Deledu's first service game. Needs to convert right here. What a difference when Deledu gets her first serve in. This time she hit it a little bit harder. Gets the short reply and is able to run around and smack the forehand.
That first serve coming in at 99 miles an hour. Her first serve percentage right now at 57%, but she has four double faults.
Advantage, Miss Deledu.
Some of the matches in progress, Mary J. Mary Jo,
two young Russians, the 10th seed Meskina, easily 6-1, and one love over Kretnerskaya.
Can I call you Mary J?
No.
No, okay. MJ.
MJ's
or Mary Jo.
That's right.
Three games all.
Deledu doing very well, very lucky. Fortunate to get those three break points back and holding on to serve. She cannot afford to continue hitting those double faults the way she's been going.
Two French women, Wah and Cameron. Wah, remember, was a lefty who took Serena three sets in Australia. And what was Pierce doing there with that racket face open like that? Look at Pierce when she gets to this drop shot. How she hits it. Looks like she's going to go hit a forehand, then look, backside.
Well, she kept the forehand grip.
She did.
And hit it with the backside of the racket. There's a good look at it.
Don't see that too often.
No. She might have even touched the net with her foot, too.
15-0.
Pierce with her second ace of the match. Jarkko Nieminen, the 30th seed, on serve. Eunice Ellenau, a 2-3 against Nicholas Massou. Opportunity here for Deledu. Remember, she was down three break points in her last service game. Now 15-30.
The minute Deledu can get Pierce on the run, she takes total control of the point. Had a deep return, and it's key for Deledu to get a return back deep so Pierce can have the first strike in the rally.
Mary Jo, what's going to put Elena Deledu in that next level of player? I mean, last year she had some good wins. When she won her first career title, won another, her second career title earlier this year, been as high as 14 in the world. Do you see her as a player who can get to that, you know, 10 in the world and start pushing those top 10 players consistently?
She's got the potential, no question about it. Shotmaker Deledu, she's only 20 years of age. She's had great wins already. She's beaten three top 10 players. Dokic last year when she was in the top 10. Anna Arden and Monica Seles. She fights well, she competes well. I think she could still get in better shape, be a little quicker around the court, and she's got to fix this serving problem. That's really been affecting her, especially this year.
Break point. In the previous service game on the break point, we saw Deledu take the approach and come in.
Hesitated that time. It's going to come in Deledu at the last minute, retreated.
Well, that's why she lost that point. You know, I think she had made the commitment to come in and then stopped and found herself kind of in no woman's land and made the retreat back behind the baseline and stayed on the defense.
Advantage, Miss Pierce.
Great placement on that first serve from Pierce. Pierce does have one of the best second serves in the women's game. She gets good racket head speed. She kicks it very well. So it's not as easy to attack your second serve, but on the grass, it'll sit up a little bit more for you to have a little more time.
Game, Miss Pierce. New balls, please.
Mary Pierce doing a solid job holding on to serve. It's the 2003 Championships Wimbledon. We're coming right back. 14th seed Eleni Danilidou of Greece taking on Mary Pierce, born in Montreal, living in, spending a lot of her time in Florida. She's a French national, forehand winner from Danilidou on this second point, 15-all.
Pierce lives in Bradenton, Florida, spent some time in Cleveland for a while she was dating Robbie Alomar, the baseball player.
30-50.
But Pierce is really trying to persevere. She's been plagued by injuries over the last few years. 2001, she missed the French, Wimbledon, and the U.S. Open. Came back last year, had a stomach strain, and she keeps plugging away.
Mary Pierce, a player who has two major championships to her name, along with two final appearances. Another double fault from Danilidou, number six. We remind you that on center court later today, Tim Henman will be in action, along with Andre Agassi and Serena Williams. We'll be bringing you coverage from all three of those matches.
Not a bad day of tennis.
That's okay. And we get to watch it all.
I still am amazed at how Henman handles all the pressure here at Wimbledon year after year. The fans just rooting him on and willing him to win. And now that Ruzetsky's out, it's all on him.
Game point. Mary Pierce not quite set yet.
Net for serve.
You mentioned Tim Henman. I remember he told me once that he feels so comfortable here actually at Wimbledon, and especially on center court, because in his first match ever on center court, he won a five-setter against Gafelnikov, saving a couple match points. And ever since that moment, he has loved being out on that court. But court number two, Eleni Danilidou, four games all, dodging another one, starting out that game with a double fault. Is that going to be her downfall of this match?
Well, she's hanging in there. I mean, she's had six double faults, saved seven break points, and it's four all. So Pierce has had a lot of opportunities she's not been able to capitalize on.
15 left.
Well, you've just got to think at some point, I mean, with saving that many double faults each and every service game, taking another look at this point.
Pierce stepping in, got the good first serve in. She just has to hit the ball waist level. She's as good as anybody.
I think with the returns of Pierce, she would get that break eventually. This point set up by the return of serve.
It's just so important that first crack you can get in a rally, whether it's a first serve or the return. It just sets up the whole point for you.
13 winners for Danilidou. And only seven unforced errors. That ball called out. Danilidou not so sure about it. Here's another look at it. She just takes a stab at this ball.
Looks like it was just wide.
Very, very close, but no argument from Mary Pierce, obviously. 30-15. Now that's just sheer power on the side of Danilidou on that backhand side. On her back foot moving backwards, just pounding it cross court. Trying to get the first break of this set. That's tremendous play from Danilidou, and now she has a break point, all set up by the backhand again.
14.
And what great disguise on this drop shot. Nobody saw this drop shot coming. She cuts underneath it just like she's going to hit a deep slice. The last minute stops it.
Break point to serve for the first set.
Deuce.
A good deep ball from Pierce.
Advantage, Miss Pierce.
We'll give Pierce credit. When she needs that first serve, she is getting them in. 67% on the match. That serve coming in at 104 miles an hour.
Okay, Ms. Pierce.
Danilidou not doing enough with the second serve return. The winner from Pierce, and Danilidou will be serving to stay in the first set. The championships, Wimbledon, Mary Pierce, 5-4 lead over the 14th seed. First point, second point. It is 15 all. Eleni Danilidou serving to stay in this first set. 44 minutes old, this set.
Pierce has had a bunch of opportunities to break the Danilidou serve, seven. Starting to play on her mind a little bit. And Mal, we talk about breaks and serves in women's tennis, usually not meaning a lot. But on grass, it's the one surface where it actually does mean a little bit more. Players on the women's side really hold their serves that much more comfortably than they would on another surface. The grass really helps the service.
30.
I think combine that with what you just said with the fact that Mary Pierce in her opening match had a very good performance on her own serve, and even today serving very good on her own serve, 64% first serve. So if she is able to get that break, very good chance she's going to be able to hold on to that break.
I used to love to return serves. I won the coin toss, and this is the only time of the year where if I won the coin toss, I elected to serve. Thought it was always a big advantage to serve first.
30-14.
Bad miss on the second serve for Danilidou, her seventh double fault. And it brings up a set point for Mary Pierce and her eighth break point opportunity of the set.
And set point.
She guessed right.
Well, that was, jeez. It was almost as if on this return, Mary Pierce isn't even ready for that.
Well, I think she was anticipating the serve of the tee. So Danilidou caught her off guard, and then Pierce ran to the open court. She actually had a pretty good look at the pass.
Anastasia Mesquina, 6-1 and 4-1. Mirko Nieminen up a set. Another action going on around the grounds.
Advantage, Miss Pierce.
So Pierce gets another set point. Currently 0 for 8 on break points. By now it's starting to get into her head a little bit. This is where
Pierce needs to move around a little bit and get into the head of Daniladou.
Get into her head, try to intimidate her on this second serve on set point. The forehand winner from Mary Pierce, the 21st winner of the set, only three unforced errors. She takes the first set, 6-4.
That match coming up. Mary Pierce searching for the sky as we get back to Mal and Mary Jo for the second set of that match.
Thanks, guys. Mary Pierce 6-4 in the first set. She saved three break points in her opening game of the second set. Daniladou was again not able to convert. Daniladou serving 30-all, second serve at the top of your screen.
Another double fault for Daniladou. Bringing up the first break point of the second set for Pierce. And this is a really important time for Mary Pierce. She's had a couple matches this year against top players where she's won the first set, played really well, and then lost her concentration, gotten a little bit tired.
For the second consecutive service game, Elena Daniladou has been broken, and now Mary Pierce in control of this match. If she can just continue to hold on to serve, this is the way things have gone thus far.
Well, Pierce has served incredibly well. She's getting a high percentage of first serves at 70%. Daniladou at 61, not bad, but she's double faulting way too many times. 8 double faults for Daniladou, 0 for Mary Pierce, and that's one of the reasons she's been able to save her break points.
And amazingly, Mary Pierce is winning a higher percentage of points on her second serve than she is on her first serve.
And that's one of the reasons why, Mal, Daniladou's blocking that second serve. We really were expecting the Greek player to hit this chip and come in, really commit herself. And that's what she did last year so well in her fourth round against Capriati, where she almost won. She was attacking every minute she could.
And if my memory serves me right, she's only used that play just once, chipping and coming in. We've seen her bluff a couple of times and fake like she's coming in and then retreat it. Left for Mary Pierce. Let's go back to the studio with Chris Fowler. We're over here watching Mary Pierce pick up her game a little bit. She had triple break point to go up two breaks in the second set. Now her and on the third break point of this game, Elena Daniladou double faulting. And I think we said it in her first service game. We saw that horrible double fault from Daniladou, that was going to be a big factor in this match. She has 10 double faults, has been broken her last three service games, and Mary Pierce is on a bit of a roll. From 4-all, she has won 6 consecutive games.
Well, she's taken advantage of the Daniladou breakdown in her serve. And I don't know about that movie. I think the guy in the headband, Mal, he looked a little questionable. I'd love to see him, like Patrick, hit a few balls.
Well, that's that play right there. That's what we've been kind of looking for from Daniladou, but a good serve off the back of the line. But the headband actually reminded me a little bit of Borg.
I think that's what he was trying to go for, but I don't know.
Let Fesef.
Coming into net, we've seen her come in a lot from the beginning of the match, and I think that really sent the message across the net to Daniladou. Look at the winners and unforced errors, 27 winners, only 5 unforced errors for Mary Pierce. Daniladou with way too many unforced errors at 16. That's a great ratio for Pierce.
Very impressive, 27 winners.
And that's coming from her serve, from her ground strokes, and from her volleys.
And I expect Mary Pierce to come up with a lot of winners off of the ground strokes, but when she's serving and volleying some and picking off volleys, then I say she's very confident in her game right now.
Well, I think it's made a big difference to reunite with her old coach, Sven Grunfeld. I think he's a calming influence on her. He took her back into the top 10 after she had dropped off in 97. Of course, was with her when she won the Australian Open in 95. I think at this time in her career, she's 28 years old, Mary Pierce. She needs somebody who knows her well, who knows how to make her work, knows the right things to say at the right time.
I think she's looking to find herself again, find her game, see if she can make one last run at the top spot.
40.
And get back to where she was, because really in the last few years, she has not been that player, or at least not since 2000 when she won the French Open, has not been that player who has been contending at the majors.
Well, she's hardly played. She's been so injured. And the one player and a good friend of hers who's, I think, inspired her has been Chanda Rubin. She's seen her go through a lot of injuries, come back, and now be in the top 10.
You mentioned Chanda Rubin playing really the last couple years, some of the best tennis of her career.
Really the last year, after having her second knee surgery, came back last spring and played incredible for 12 months, was one of the few players to beat Serena Chanda in the summer. And she's been to the round 16 or better of the last four Grand Slams. And I think that's really giving Mary a little confidence that, okay, if I work hard enough, maybe I can get back too.
Rubin threw yesterday over Amy Frazier, and Mary Pierce has a game point, second serve. Solid play from Mary Pierce. She is one game away from the third round. We're coming back.
Martina Hingis and Martinez. So it was a great accomplishment for Mary Pierce to win in France.
15 career titles, 9 doubles titles in her career. Showing a little versatility with the touch on the forehand drop shot. Love 15.
Tremendous career, even though she's been on and off the tour for the last couple of years with injuries. She's been in 18 finals, including 2 majors. And from 91 to 2000, 8 of those 10 years, she won at least one singles title. That's a really good record for Pierce.
Eight of 9 years in the heyday of Mary Pierce. She was in the top 15. For 6 years, she was in the top 7 in the world, got to a career high number 3. Elena Danilidou certainly hoping to have some of those results on her career resume at some point.
Meskina, 10th seed, Russian, defeating countrywoman Krasnoskaya, straights. Looks like it's going to go in the third between the French women, Cameron and Loire.
15.
Now we're seeing Danilidou relax a little bit and go for her shots. Combination of Pierce really being on her game and serving well, not allowing Danilidou to attack, but also Danilidou being a little too tentative, a little too cautious against Pierce today.
How much of this do you think is pressure? Because last year she won one of the warm-up tournaments on grass leading into Wimbledon, came to Wimbledon, made the round of 16. In the warm-up this year, losing first round, and here in the second round about to go out. How much of that is pressure?
It can definitely play on your mind when you know you have points to defend and you don't want to see your ranking drop. She went from 14 to 21. Now she's going to drop a little bit more, so it could be in the back of her mind.
And not to take anything away from Mary Pierce and the tennis that she's playing. Pierce leading 5-1 because she is playing a very clean and solid match. But Danilidou not playing quite the style today that we thought she might. We thought she might chip in charge and try to bring it to Mary Pierce a little bit more.
That's right, and she was not able to do that at all.
Ball kids changing to new balls. Changing after 7 and 9 games.
Mary Pierce lost first round in both Australia and at the French. did not play any warm-up tournaments leading up to Wimbledon, but had an impressive double bagel in her first round against Ainsley Cargill from Georgia. And now a very solid performance against the Greek, seeded number 14.
Fifteen love.
We remind you, coming up very soon, Tim Henman will be taking the court, center court. Serena Williams will be taking court number one later on, following Andre Agassi.
Serena playing against an opponent who gave her trouble last year, Els Callens, number three player in Belgium, a veteran.
Couple of tie breaks Serena had with her last year.
Tricky player. You can chip and charge, serve and volley. Likes the grass. Serena said she was extremely nervous the other day stepping onto center court. First match back after winning last year. Took her a while to get settled. I expect her to play a little bit better in her second round, and she'll be ready for Callens.
What is that? Thank you,
Mary.
So Mary Pierce, 107 miles an hour on that serve, 2 points from the third round. Maybe that's why Elena Danilidou has not been using that player.
Well, no pressure for Pierce to come up with the pass at 6-4, 5-1. You do it early enough in the match that later on it becomes more effective. But two match points now for Mary Pierce.
Pierce threw very comfortably, decided to serve and volley a little bit on that match point, 6-4 and 6-1. Mary Jo, how do you like her game right now, taking out the 14th seed?
It has improved a lot. I mean, she came up to the net so much, won 20 points at the net, and she advances to the third round, where she most likely will face Lisa Raymond, a past quarterfinalist here. Good serve and volley. That's going to be a tough matchup for Mary Pierce. And then Anna Arden is the most likely one to get through there, the French Open champ this year.
Also in that top half of the draw, Jennifer Capriati, Serena Williams, Mary Pierce through in straight sets. Coming up, everybody, Tim Henman takes center court.